Welcome. What are we learning today? We're learning about relays. This is lesson number 6 on electrical. I'll be sure to leave links in the description with a simple lesson 1, lesson 2, lesson 3. I suggest you watch them in order. You mix or match, whatever you do. We're taking it to another level. We started with some basics, but let's get busy. Come on down, let me show you what I have. Same thing. I have a variation of relays. Oh, I guess I can start with the colors. I have a green one, I have a yellow, I have a blue, I have a gray. I have different relays here. You see them? I have different relays. Okay, what you need to understand is that the relay is nothing more than this. And I bet you recognize what this is. Well, that's just a switch at your house. These guys are the same thing, but the only difference is you don't reach over and turn these on. It's hardwired. I'm going to start to show you how to work with circuits with the relay. Now, let's start with the easy part. Where is it? Let me see if I can find it. Where is the easy one? The easy one, right there. This is an easy one. This one is easy because the size of the terminals are screaming information. You're going to learn the two larger terminals are going to be for the load. Let me make sure you understand what loads are. Come on up. The load, the electrical load. That's the thing we put to work. For example, the blower motor is a load. We put it to work. A fuel pump motor, it's a load. We put it to work. Fuel injectors / solenoids, we put them to work. These are examples of electrical loads, the thing we put to work. We're going to hook all of this up. One of the other common electrical loads are ignition coils. If you have a gasoline engine, I bet you got a bunch of ignition coils, and we put these to work. So far, every single one of these loads that I have mentioned is operated, can be operated by the relay. What have I left out? Not too much more. This is a magnetic coil out of an AC compressor. This is a load. I'm going to show you how relays are wired with the load. Our specialty is showing you, not just telling you, but showing you. Let me show you how a relay works. I'm going to start with my battery. We've gone over batteries. I know this is a booster, but pretty much this does represent your car battery. Over here, I bet you can recognize what this monster is. This is a starter motor. So let me kind of start to hook this up and show you. I'm going to take my negative 12 volts. I am going to connect to the ground. I'm going to remind you what a bunch of amps looks like. Now, I am bypassing the solenoid, and I want you to look right here. There should be a whole bunch of spark, and the starter should operate. You see that? Good. Now, let's start to wire it up. This is how it's wired on your vehicle. The positive cable goes right here. The negative cable goes right here. Now, there is a special terminal on the starter. A special terminal on the starter. In this particular case, it's this one. And in order for you to help understand, I'm going to symbolize the ignition switch using this key. Now, all I have to do is give this some positive. And I have some right here, and that's what I'm going to do. This is how the starter circuits and many other circuits were wired. The important part, I want you to look at the tip of the key. I want you to see the spark, because the spark represents the amperage. I have a whole video on that. Here we go. When I connect it, I'm going to intentionally spark it. Spark it means connect, disconnect, connect, disconnect, so you can see the spark. Now, I'm a good guesser, and we could measure it, and we've measured it before. This spark, can you see it? This is about 10 amps. Okay, that's the way the circuits used to be wired up, but now we're going to bring in a relay. Here it is, the star of the show. This one is screaming information. We take whatever we can. This is an awesome, awesome relay for several reasons. First, we have very large, meaty terminals. Compared to some of the other relays that don't have much meat on them. Meat means material. These are basically the same, but this is a really quality relay because of the size of the terminals. You see those two sizes? We're going to identify this as the load section. This is going to operate the load. This is our load. And I'm going to start to hook this up. When we get to the hood, you'll start to see how this is important. We're going to concentrate on the load section first, then we'll go to the other section. All I'm doing is taking a jumper wire here. I'm going to take another jumper wire there. All right, I get some positive here. I have this here. I'm sure if I put these together, the starter will operate. That's how it's wired. Here, I come into the large terminal. Here, nothing's going to happen. I come into that particular terminal. I'm going somewhere with this. Okay, now it's time to wire the other section. The name of the other section is called the control. Let me go ahead. Yes, here's the problem with electrical. It doesn't take more than one wire and it gets complicated. I have so far three wires and two cables and they're coming and going, and yes, this is complicated. So how do you overcome that? I tell the students, one wire at a time. I had a few guys, well, let's do two or three wires, forget it. When you're doing electrical, you do one circuit wire at a time so you can stay organized. Now, I know what to do, and I don't need to explain a whole lot more, but let's see if this is going to work for me. I'm getting ready to show you the major advantage of a relay. Okay, here it is. You saw the spark earlier, and I'm still going to represent it the same way. All right, all I have to do now is one more thing, and then we're almost ready to go to our favorite place. I know it's complicated, I can see it, but if I can do it, you can do it. One wire at a time. Here is the major advantage of using relays in so many circuits. Right here, look at the spark. Now, I'm going to operate this huge starter, and it's not even on the engine. When they're on the engine, they use over 100 amps easy. I am going to operate this huge electrical load through, and I doubt you even see it, right here. You see it? No, you don't. You don't see it. What don't you see? You don't see the spark. Do you hear the starter? You hear the starter? Let's work the starter. There's the starter. Right there, we're working the starter. We are controlling a huge amount of amperage through a tiny little connection. Here is the major advantage of relays. Before relays, the switch. Ignition switch, headlight switch, wiper switch, AC switch, the switch. The switch was responsible for handling the load, 10 amps, 15 amps, XYZ amps, different amps. But now, the switch doesn't do that. The switch is only responsible for handling a tenth of an amp. These relays, that's all it takes. I'm a measuring fool. It takes a tenth of an amp to engage these. These are the same thing, except this one is hardwired. I've got a couple of wires that use barely any amps, and my other video explains that. The major advantage of using relays is that all the switches on your steering wheel, your dash, wherever they are in the console, the switches, the wires, the connections, they can be smaller and lighter duty. And that's okay because now they're only energizing the relay. Okay, I think we're warmed up. It's time to go to our favorite place, at least my favorite place. Let's put some of our new learned savvy to work. The hood. Let's go to the hood as far as under the hood. Okay, folks, here we are at the electrical box. Let's see if this box is a little bit friendly. So far, no information on the outside, but let's look over here. Yes, this is a friendly box. There's information for us. Now, we did the starter earlier, and we're going to do the same thing. Understanding the relays and the circuit that goes with it is so important. Watch this. A true professional. A vehicle comes in. You turn the key. Nothing. He uses this information. He doesn't look anything up. He identifies the starter relay. He takes the relay out. He looks at the relay. And if the relay is friendly, watch what he can do in about 2 seconds. We're going to take this very simple little test tool in the right hands. This is an amazing tool. Now, I'm just jumping ahead a whole bunch because I have to slow down and show you some variation that occurs. I've connected to one side of the load. We're on the starter relay. I'm expecting this engine to crank. No, it's not going to run because the key is not on, but I just did 2 major tests. I tested the fuse without even touching it. I tested the fuse. I also tested the starter without raising it up, hitting on the solenoid. I didn't do anything. I did a lot. I did 2 things. I tested the fuse and the starter. It's that easy. The load section can be so easy. Now, of course, this vehicle is cooperating. There's really nothing wrong with the starter circuit, but let's pretend you did that and your AC compressor didn't work, or your wipers didn't work, or your starter didn't work, or whatever didn't work. This is what you're going to do. The handy dandy test light. Okay, not all the relays are laid out this simple. You have to understand the different relays are wired differently, and that's the challenging part, adapting to the variation. I'm focusing on the 2 larger terminals, which happen to be copper. One of those should have voltage. I have a test light, it's ready to go, and sure enough, there it is. One of the larger ones should have positive voltage. If it doesn't, the fuse is blown. Now, the last video, again, this is a series, and you should watch them again and more than once and in order or mix it up. I am testing the fuse without even touching it. And I just tested the starter without even touching it. Most of the time it passes these two tests. Let's go to the hard part. The hard part, okay? It's called the control section. Okay, and we're just gonna snoop around a little bit. The key is in the off position. We're done. We're done with these two. The fuse is good, starter is good. We're done. Now it's time to go to these other two. Now I'm probing, and I'm not afraid of 12 volts. So right now I have nothing. I'm making sure my test light's ready to go. Three down and one to go. The relay is an absolutely perfect place to do your testing. I can test everything. What do I mean by everything? I tested the fuse. I tested the starter, I tested the ground. I am about to test the ignition switch without having to take the steering column wheel apart to test it. I can test it here. The wiring diagram explains it to me, and that's where we're headed probably on our next electrical lesson. On this particular one, I'm gonna ask my partner to crank release. Crank, release. Crank means turn the key to the start position and release. Partner, please. Crank, release. Crank, release. Perfect. I just tested the ignition switch. If this didn't turn on, I'd have to go testing that way. If the starter didn't engage, I'd have to go testing that way. If the fuse didn't have power, I'd go testing this way. If the negative didn't have negative, the diagram will tell me everything. This is an example of how this is absolutely the best place to do your testing. Thank you. Let's finish up. So, what do you think? Have any questions? I reply to almost 100% of the questions. If you have a comment, I'd like to hear from you. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you learned something, hit that notice bell so we can keep you updated. And the most important thing, if you had a little fun learning, well, I accomplished my goal. If you haven't subscribed yet, please help us out. Share it with your friends. Thank you for the view. Until next time.